has been desolate for 20 years now. After the final Great World War, our governments have destroyed every last resource left. The human population has been disgraced.
Amarantha is sitting on the remains of what used to be the Golden Gate Bridge, looking off into where San Francisco used to be.
How sad. Their pathetic lives are so short.
Marie, Griselda, Rose, and Bobo wander in and continue to think about on how to survive in their new home. As they wander, Ari sees a beautiful blue creature that clearly looks mad, but she also sees her fingers moving feverishly.
What is that thing?
I don't know. Griselda, you should go poke it.
Okay. What are you doing?
One approaches the creature with the strange device, wary of her intentions. But
what is that thing?
You don't have to trouble your little mind about it, but I will tell you that it supersedes all of human technology.
How? What does it do?
What doesn't it do? It can teleport you anywhere, and the best thing is that I can easily communicate with anyone in the galaxy.
Ooh, let me see!
No, get away from me!
Runs towards her, even the dog. Through all the yelling and pushing, Rose accidentally pushes a button on the device, causing it to whir, and then a sudden burst of light startles them. They are sucked into the light, and then they're gone.
What is this place? How did we get here?
Stupid humans, he clicked the teleportation setting on my device and it transported us home. Now what should we do?
Suddenly, a thought strikes Amarantha. The only way to get rid of those foolish creatures would be to kill them. Of course, she knew that she couldn't outright kill them, because what would be the fun in that? So she decided it would be best if she picked them off one by one.
Delicious, even though I don't know what I was eating.
It seems as though we have eaten a burrito.
Wait, what?
Where's Bobo?
Right after eating, Amarantha and the girls end up going to a movie theater.
They head into the building and the lady in front suddenly starts to speak and directs them towards some seats in the amphitheater. She presses a button on her device and the same bright light envelops them.
Wow, is this a palace?
It is essential that the four queens bow.
There in the parlor is seated Queen Bee. She gazes at her subject with interest at the guest she has brought.
How kind of all of you to come and visit. My darlings, are you human? I'm so sorry for what your world has come. Don't fret. You are so safe here on
the resort. Thank
you, Your Highness. Go and enjoy our delicious sweets.
Thank you.
looks directly at Amarantha and sends a clear message with her smile, "Get rid of them."
All leave, they head towards a cliff with a perfect view of the sunset. As Griselda and Amarantha race towards the edge, Griselda are unaware of Amarantha's intentions. As they stand at the edge of the cliff, about to sit down and enjoy the view, Amarantha forcefully pushes her off towards the abyss.
And everything goes black.
No!
Alisa wakes up, her heart hammering. She looks around and sees that she is in her room. As she looks around, she looks out her window to see San Francisco alive and thriving, yet right next to her is her cell phone. She sees the phone and all it says is "click me."
We were a community. They made me their leader when I never asked to be. But the lightning in their eyes hardened me into whatever they needed me to become. We were hopeful we would win, because nothing could scare us. We feared no city, and we feared no man.
Cigarettes in tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect inside her new Balenciaga. Viral mess turned dreams into an empire, self-made success. Now she rolls with Rockefellers. Survival of the richest, the city's ours until the fall. They're Monaco and Hampton's bound, but we don't feel like outsiders at all. We are the new Some say he looks just like his father, but he could never love somebody's daughter. Football team loved more than just the game, so he vowed to be his husband at the altar. Survival of the richest, the city's ours until the fall. They're Monaco and Hampton's bound, but we don't feel like outsiders at all. We are.